All right, we're back here at CAP, Central Arizona Project. Now, last time we were here, hold on, I just heard somebody behind me. Nope. Okay. The last time we were here, it was 100 degrees, couldn't get too far up on that, by the canal. So we're gonna see how far we can get because the weather is great. So I think it'll hit 79 today. It's somewhere in the 60s right now. But anyway, it's early in the morning. Well, not that early. So this canal here is 336 miles long. That's pretty long. And they started it in 1973, and they ended it at 1993, so that was 20 years. That's a long time, and 6 million people benefit from this canal here. It comes from the Colorado River, Lake Havasu, and it has like 456 billion gallons per year. So that's a lot. You can see it over here. Once we get up top, you'll see it even better. But I think they have cows in the field way back over there. Pretty sure they do. All right, let's get up on that mound right there. And oh, they've been doing a lot of work here too. If you look over there, they're making the parking lot a lot bigger and maybe putting another, I don't know what they're doing. Maybe putting extra buildings, whatever they're doing. But I'm parked over there and I'm the only one here. Nobody is here. A lot of times the bicyclists come here to get up on there and ride, you know, miles down that canal. But, I'm the only one here. Let's check it out. All right, instead of walking all the way down there to get up on the hill, I think there's a little thing over here that people made because they didn't want to walk way over there. Let's see if it's still here. Okay, here it is. I don't know if I can get up here, to be honest with you, without slipping and sliding. Let's give it a shot. Whoa. Whoa. So far, so good. Coming down is gonna be another story. Wow, easier than I thought. Okay, we're up. Wow. See, otherwise you gotta walk all the way down there. Yeah, maybe I can make it down. All right, so I think there's cows. There's a big cow farm, ranch, somewhere back there. Maybe we'll see some, I don't know. Whew. All right. Now, last time we were here, I got about right out down there. It was too hot, 100 degrees, whatever it was. Couldn't go too far. So let's see how far we can get. See what the heck's back here. So here's the canal, and that goes along. It goes under, I think it goes underground, and then shoots that way somewhere. Oh no, there it is. It goes right over there. I don't know exactly where it goes, but I'm pretty sure it goes that way, miles. It ends up down where I live, Now I did some work, security work. Where are we right now? Way down there, about, I don't know, 10 miles that way. There's a little area where they divert water that goes to the farmers, and they were working on it or something, so they needed security there. So if you look at some of my old videos, like a year or two, I don't know how long ago it was, but I'm literally right on this thing, and I could see the fish. There's all kinds of shells that come up when it overflows because of the little snails or whatever's in there. So, oh, here comes a bike rider. I guess I'm not alone. All right, let's keep on going. We'll be looking for cows. I might put the drone up. We'll see, because it is kind of windy. It's a little windy. There's a lot of horse manure too. So people do ride the horse up here, which would be a nice little ride. So there's two trenches on each side. And then you see that pipe. So when it overflows, it goes into the trenches. And until it recedes, then it will start going back into the canal. They don't want to waste any water. So all that they dug out of here is right here. So it's not as windy as it was where I parked. For some reason, it's better up here. Still no cows. I don't see anything out there. There should be some deer running through there. Maybe we'll spot some of those, and coyotes, maybe even javelina. It looks like the water is down a little bit, actually. Looks like a foot, it's down a foot. Oh wow, speaking of cows, here's one over there in the construction area. He just came up. That's funny. I knew they were out here. He just gave a moo because he don't know where the heck he is. That's funny. He's totally lost. Now here's where we made it last time, to this thing here. I wonder if you could walk through that. I know it smelled like hell last time I went down there to look at it, and we just left because, like I said, it was 100 degrees, but let me go take another look. Could that possibly be for cows to walk through? No, you know what I think that is? I think somehow they get water from here and then they shoot it out to the farmers. And I don't think they shoot it that way. Maybe just that way because I see a little canal over there. That's pretty funny. That cow just popped up out of the canal. He's just walking around like, what the heck is all this? Poor cow. Okay, it was down here. please stay on the trail. I'm just gonna go check this out. Like I said, last time I looked in there, it stunk really bad. Okay, let me get over here. I don't want to get too close. Could be something in there that I don't know about. Wow. It's big enough to walk through. What the hell? Holy crap. You can get right through it. I see some water in this one. Let's check over here. Less water over here. Let me check this one. There's something down there. Wow, so this might be where the cow was walking through. All right, let's go over to this one. Let me just check over here. Yeah, cow footprints. So maybe they were going through here. I didn't bring my flashlight, so I don't know what the hell's going on in here. This is strange. I'm underneath the canal right now. Yeah, there's footprints in the dirt. Cows are definitely going through here. I think I better... I can say, put a light on. Because it could be a rattlesnake. Although I don't see any. Wow, what is going on here? It doesn't even smell. Last time it was horrible smell. What the heck is that? Can't tell. I can't even believe I'm walking through this thing. What the hell? We got bones. We got a skeleton. Big one. Deer. Could be deer. Yeah, look at that. Holy crap. There's some coyote footprints. I guess I gotta walk over here. Let's hope there's no... Here's another bone. What the hell? Somebody was eating something. Holy shit. There's some more. It's a cow. Something attacked a cow. Look at this thing. Look at that big piece. Wow, there's your cow skin. Holy crap. There's the foot. Look at this. Wow, poor cow. I wonder what happened. Okay, there's a fence around this whole area right here. Unless you can get in over there. And I don't see the cow. He's heading towards probably that train or that way. So I think that cow actually came from over there. So if you get through here, let me see that over there. No, I don't think you can get through over there. Very strange to find a dead cow. That's a first. Let me check this. Could they get through over here? Nope, they're not getting through there either. All right, well, that solves that problem. This is basically just to allow water to flow from one way to the other, whichever way it's flowing. Not really sure. Yeah, we got bones everywhere. Let's get back over here. All right. Let's get through this thing. Nice breeze coming this way. All right, let's get back on the trail. All right, actually, we weren't under the water. We were on top. For some dumb reason, I thought we were under the water. I can see the cow. He's way, way over there by those blue things. He's just roaming around. So I am seeing cow patties, but they're very old. But you can see, you can go up each side and come right up here. So I'm sure they were up here at some point. See? Really old. I haven't seen anything fresh up here. And I don't see any cows out there where our friend was. He's still wandering around back there. Well, you can see Picacho Peak way over there. We've been over there a lot. Nice view. Okay, it's 72 right now. They changed it, so now it's gonna hit 80. I didn't notice it was getting a little hotter. Still not as bad as 100. It looks like there's another one of those crossovers over there. Probably another 10-minute walk. I think I'll take a break once I get up there because it is getting a little hot. There must be a massive ant colony underneath this thing that goes, I'm seeing hole after hole after hole of ants. And they could be fire ants. I mean, there must be a million of them under here. And look, every so often, boom. These don't look like fire ants, but they might be newborn, whatever's. These are littler, blacker ants. Maybe they are fire ants, I don't know. They're not red. Uh-oh. I thought I heard some cows. Maybe not. That might be a cow under a tree. Let me zoom in on that, right there. I think that's a cow sitting under a tree. Wow, this is taking forever. It's further than it looks. Haven't seen any other cows. They might all be just sitting in the shade. And nothing on that side at all. Okay, besides that plane you hear, I did hear a noise like a cow mooing. So I think they're in the shade and you're not gonna see them. Definitely heard it. All right. I think once we get over here, that's as far as we go. It's almost like 2 miles. And it is getting hot. Not as hot as 100 yet, I know. But still, it's hot when you're walking. I got a heavy backpack on me. Yeah, I gotta find me some shade somewhere. Let's see, I probably can go underneath or through that pipe. All right, finally, we made it. So I'm gonna go down here, see what's going on. I may have to go find some shade over here to take a break. Doesn't seem to be any right here. Got the same thing right here. Let's see, yep. Same thing. Let's just take a look inside. Might be something in there. Yep. Okay. Now I gotta find, I don't know, maybe I'll hang out right here. Wow, what kind of little tracks are these? Baby something. Yeah, I'm just gonna sit right here. Take a break. I think I'll put the drone up just to look around. And then we'll head on back. This is a good place for the drone to land. They always have problems of the propellers hitting stuff unless you have a nice flat surface. All right, let's head on back. If I had more time, I would like to just walk straight out and see what's out there. I know there's a lot of washes, but maybe next time. All right, so I'm guessing they put these in wherever there was a natural wash, the bigger washes. So they had to put them in there, otherwise you'd have massive flooding and they don't want to interrupt the natural order of things, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. Yeah, there's the wash there. Comes around, goes right through. Anyway, that was interesting. Got a long walk back, or hike, whatever you want to call it. Now I got the wind in my face, which is good. All right, I'll see you when we get to the end. This is way too long of a walk, a hike. Keep saying walk. Wow, check it out. It's a steer, I think. I think there's horns, yeah. Hold on. Yeah, it's a steer, I guess. He's heading back. He said, I had enough of civilization. That's pretty funny. Okay, he's deciding, yeah, I'm not going back there. Wow, I was looking at this rock and I was about to leave and I just happened to look over here. I cannot believe this is what I'm looking at. Oh my God, here's another one. Holy crap, pottery. Look at the size of it. I have to wash it and see if there's anything on it. But that's one. What is this? Here's another piece. Put it up there so I can clean it off. Oh, here's a smaller piece. Small one. Now, here's the thing. They dug all that up out there and dumped it here. So the Hohokam were in this whole big area. Let's see if I can find, oh, here's some more. You gotta be kidding me. Never expected to find pottery here. That is crazy. So that means there was a ton of it through there in order for it to get up top here and wash out. That means there's probably pottery all throughout this whole thing here. Well, it could be in certain sections, but what are the odds of me finding it looking down? Here's another one. Let's look down here. Here's another piece. Little pieces. Here's another piece. Where did I put the other one over there? All right, let's look around just to check. Not gonna keep this, just gonna leave it here. But I wanna see if there's any writing on it, or I mean painting. Wow, that is crazy. I guess as I'm walking back, I should be looking down. All right, let me wash this big one off. Okay. Yep, there's some red painting markings on it. So there's a big one. I just found this one just by, it's red on one side. The rest of them are just normal. Wow, what a surprise. Who'd have thought? Well, I'll keep looking as I'm walking down and see what we can find. The rest of this is getting tossed down there. So let's just push that over there. Nobody will see it. And we'll keep looking. Okay, I've been walking right along here. And I'm just picking it up like it's going out of style. It's everywhere. Look, as I'm walking, there's two there. There's a big one here. All right, but look at all this. Look at it all. And here's one that was, I've never seen one that fat before. That's the biggest one I've seen fat. But check this out. This one could have been, it's broke, but it's rounded. They might have been using this as jewelry maybe or something. You don't normally see this. So I'm gonna send a picture of this to my brother and see what he says. Well, it's now it's drying up over here. Well, that was interesting. All right, I got a long way to go. I'm just recently getting back to this one. Is that a blue herring over there? I think that's a blue herring. He would definitely, he could travel this thing 300 miles and there's fish all in there. He'd be kikuyu to eat for the rest of his life. Let me see if he's, oh, he keeps going. I might catch up to him. Wow, just made it back to this one. That was a long one. It's gonna be over 3 miles. There and back. I'll check it when I get back, but it's pretty far. Haven't seen any more pottery. Probably just in that one section. All right, finally to the end. Gotta be kidding me. I'll let you know how many miles that was once I get back to my truck over there. Anyway, say goodbye to that thing I found. My brother said it was probably a gaming piece, not a necklace. Like they used it for gaming or something like that. You know, it could not worth anything. Even if it had a hole in it and it was a necklace, still not worth anything. I mean, for someone's collection, I guess it's nice. But it was broke, but they were probably using it, like you said, for something. Maybe money, maybe that's what they used for money back then, I don't know. But probably like a gaming, kids were playing something, made it and playing a game or something. They did have ball courts, and maybe that's what they were betting on or something, I don't know. I'm not an expert on the hokum. I don't know that much. But, let's get the hell out of here. Let me see what the mileage is right from here. So it was 3.2 to here. Put another 0.2 to my truck. 3.4 or 5, 3.5 miles, say. Now this is the longest I've walked or hiked since the 90s and 100s. In fact, I can't even believe I did it. I guess it's a bit hot. I thought it was going to be in the like high 60s or something like that, or maybe low 70s. But is this where I came up? Let me see. I think so. Yeah, I think this is where I came up. Okay, I don't know if I can get down here without falling. Let's give it a shot. Going down is a lot harder. You can slip very easily. Whoa. All right, thanks for watching as usual. See you on the next one. Wow, I even got a little bit burnt, I can feel it. But if you look way over there, there's the horse trough, I believe, or cattle, for cattle. They put water in there. We had checked that out last time we were here. But I'm not gonna go walk over there again. All right, like I said, thanks for watching. See you on the next one. And we got a train. Oh, wow. I lucked out. Usually these things go on for miles. All right, so it did turn out to be almost 4 miles. That's the furthest I've walked in a long time. So that's the first step. Just got to start doing it more and more. All right, thanks for watching. See you on the next one.